So I will start with the basics of EDI. Just I will throw quickly. So already both are aware. So what is EDI? So it's EDI, it's electronic data interchange. So before EDI coming into existence, so the business happened over emails or faxes or something other else, like paper invoices or paper orders, how we are following in India. So later, so all the Americans or US people or European regions people decided to form an organization and to have a standard. So that this standard should be followed by all other. Okay. So that is how the EDI is emerged. So these are the two trading partners. So two trading partners, how they exchange their business documents without any human intervention is nothing but an EDI. So now we are all in, now we are working under B2B domain. Okay, so it's a business to business. How the hello?
Yes.
Okay. So if you have any questions, you can drop me. Okay. So yeah, business to business is nothing but so how the transactions means how the goods are delivering between manufacturer, wholesaler, wholesaler to supplier, not to and retailer, but not to consumer. If the consumer is, it is B2C. So B2B. So all are doing business here. Manufacturer is doing business, wholesaler is doing business, and retailer is doing business. So all belongs to B2B side only.
Okay.
So this is how the before the EDI that the just earlier I've explained. So before EDI, what happened and what is going to be done. So how EDI came into existence. It's a small biography. So it's a technical format. So EDI will have some standards like ANSI X12, ADIFACT, VICS, TDCC. So there are different formats available for EDI standards. I can say standards available, but mostly we'll go with the ANSI X12 and then ADIFACT. If you compare ANSI X12 ADIFACT, we'll go for more into ANSI X12 because number of partners are US partners. Okay. So EDI means some standards. Okay, which will follow by our trading partners. They will exchange their own business documents with each other without any human intervention. That is called EDI. So these are the many advantages. So there will be less human intervention. So there will be no errors. A high production can be available. So it will be turnaround time is very quick and more security. So in this way, so EDI is very helpful nowadays. So how are the companies using EDI? So nowadays in US or Europe, mostly all industries, in government sectors and claims, health claims processing. Okay, that's called HIPAA flow. Okay, so healthcare, banking, industry, all were following. Now EDI itself. Now, there are some of the standards. So in that, the first one is ANSI X12. So we'll call as American National Standard Institute. For you, this with the ANSI X12 will be followed by US region. Okay. The next is ADIFACT. So ADIFACT is then followed by the all Europe region. So it's called as EDI for administration, commerce and transport. So EDACC, VICS is also one of the formats that I have never used. And another format also has is Tradacoms. That is also used in one of the European region only. But all, compared to all, these two are the main, ANSI X12 and ADIFACT. If you compare both ANSI X12 and ADIFACT, then ANSI X12 is more usable. So what are the basic differences between ANSI X12 and ADIFACT means? In ANSI X12, so we'll call as a transactions. 850, some transactions will be there called 850, 855, 810. But in ADIFACT, we'll call as a messages, like orders, invoice. Okay, for orders, for 850, we'll call as orders 850, right? Here, ORDRS. Like that, for every transactions, we'll have some messages. Okay, in ANSI X12, I'll tell you later. I will explain you what is segment and element, and then I'll tell you. Okay, so enveloping and parsing. What is enveloping and what is parsing? So enveloping means the process of combining multiple documents. Okay, so it means that I assume while you're sending an outbound document to our trading partner. So we have a backend system called SAP. From SAP, we'll send an IDOC format. Okay. So Bala, do you know what is IDOC format?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Very good. So IDOC is nothing but an intermediate document, it's a full form where it is, it will be understood by only SAP systems. So SAP system will send an IDOC document. But if you send the same IDOC to trading partner, means trading partner can't understand. Trading partner is EDA system. So what our job here is to receive IDOC from SAP and convert them to EDI and then send to trading partner. This is our job. Okay. So when we will receive IDOC from SAP using some protocols. Later I will explain you how to set up and everything. And then once come to Sterling Integrator, the document will have a mapping concept. Okay, that mapping concept is used to transform from one format to other format, whatever, how you design. Okay, so and then the EDA file will come. Here enveloping means after the EDA file generated, we don't have envelope setup like IAS, GS, ST, IES, we'll have some segments and elements, right? The commons, that one will not be there. So that one also in the enveloping concept, we'll add those and then we'll send to trading partner. This is what enveloping. So in business process, it will be explained more clear, like creating envelopes and everything. Parsing means whenever we receive an inbound document from trading partner, we'll receive with ISA, GS, ST, so like EDA format. But if you send the same EDA document to SAP system, means it will be failed. SAP can't understand that flow format. Now here our job is to collect the EDA file from trading partner and convert into IDOC file and then send to the SAP system. This is about the inbound flow. Here, while sending to SAP system, we'll remove all the ISA, GS, ST. Means we are doing parsing. Okay? That is called enveloping and parsing. This we'll discuss more in the while creating a business process and everything. Okay. So, now translation. Just now, earlier I have said, you know, translation means nothing but converting from one format to other formats. Use some software. It's nothing but translation. Okay, the background is map editor only. Okay. So general small inbound and outbound. So inbound means in most of the time we'll receive EDA files only. So we receive EDA files and using map editor, it will be translated and then translated file will send to the application data, means that the SAP system mainframes or any JD AdWord systems. Any other backend system. This is inbound. Outbound means we'll receive a flat file or application file or IDOC file from backend systems and we'll convert into EDA format and then send to the trading part. This is outbound flow. So basically, what is inbound and what is outbound? Okay. So this is how the transaction means the ANSI Extrol standard looks like. Whenever you see these words like ISA, GS, ST, SC, GIA, the okay. ANSI X12 standard. Okay, so yeah. ANSI X12, ISA means, so for how in the Java we'll have open and closing tag, the similar thing for ISA also we'll have a closing tag like IEA. For GS we'll have GE as a closing tag. For ST we'll have SC as a closing tag. Okay, ISA means it's an interchange header. IEA means interchange trailer. Okay. GS means functional group header. GE means functional group trailer. ST means transaction set header. SC means transaction set trailer. Okay. So for each, we'll call ISA segments. Okay. Yes. These are all our segments. After segment, in here we'll have some elements. Yes, we'll have some elements. So elements. Okay. So ISA segments are separated by using the default, we'll call delimiter. Delimiter means separators.
Separators.
Okay. Okay. For segment, segment separator, we'll call tilde. It's a default one. Any symbols we can use, but default tilde segment segment delimiter. To differentiate between the elements, we'll call as element delimiter. Usually in ANSI X12, we'll use star as an element delimiter. Okay? But you, if you ask me, is this common and do we need to use only star and tilde? My answer is no. Okay, it's a trading partner wish. Whatever the symbols they use, there is, but the default symbols I am saying now. Okay. So if for each having, we have ISA, we have a fixed length. Means it consists of 16 elements. The 16 elements length, if you count, means the length is 106. That's why we'll call as an fixed length, it is 106. But okay. GS segments, ST segments are variable length. So it can be the variable length, 86 something will be there. But it can be variable. So sometimes 70, sometimes nothing. So 70 below 85, like that will be there. It's not a fixed length. Okay, only ISS segment only, we have fixed length. Means 106. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So and yeah, tell me.
So in ISA IA segment, GSHT, how many it will be repeat like that? Depend on the.
Yeah, I'm telling the next one, that one only. So in one ISA and one IEA, we can have 5 9s of GSGS. 5 9s. That okay. means GSGS we can have in one ISA and one IEA. But we'll not see that file in ever. But as per the ADA standards, we can have 5 9s of GSGS in one ISA. Okay. In similar to that, in one GSGE, we can have 5 9s of STSs, means 99999 like that number. So 5 9 times of STSs can be have in one GSGE.
Okay.
Okay.
But ISA IA only repeated only one time, right?
It's only one time.
Only one.
Multiple, because we are receiving from only one trading partner. Under one trading partner, we can have number of divisions. Just that is GSGE. Under GSG, we can have multiple orders.
Okay. We have multiple orders inside ISA and IEA, but ISA IEA will be only one interchange control header, right?
Yeah, only for belongs to one trading partner here. You can't have multiple, right? If you are sending me, you will be the sender. I am the receiver.
Okay.
Okay. If Bala is sending me, Bala will send another one because assume is a mobile number. You will call me. You will call with your mobile number only.
Okay.
Okay, but mobile number is unique. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have one.
Okay.
If multiple trading partner want the same map, like global map, if I want to send a global map to the 20 customers, so at that moment, it will be same ISA IE?
It will differentiate using envelopes. Okay. So you are saying you are sending, right? That is nothing but outbound. So that is next call in the business process. So we'll have an envelope setup for each trading partner. We'll have each envelope setup and bucket to transactions. So in that envelope setup, we'll assign a new map for every trading partner. We'll have assigned a map. So in that way, it will come. It will send to different partners. Okay. So this is nothing, same sheet. So now what is interchange envelopes and what is functional group, what is message envelopes? So interchange is nothing but an ISA standard. In ISA, it will enclose all GS and GS. Okay. So enclose all functional group envelopes, interchange means. Functional group envelopes means it will enclose all STSs. So nothing but transaction sets. So message or transaction envelopes we'll call as this. So it will enclose all the transaction related segments. Okay, so what is BEG means some segments will be there under STSC. That segments will be enclosed in STSC, in transaction set. Okay, now we are seeing EDIFAC standard. Okay. Now this is EDIFAC standard. Similar how we are having in ANSI X12 like ISA, GS, ST. Now it is EDIFAC standard. In EDIFAC, we'll have UNB and UNZ, whereas in ANSI X12, ISA and IEA. Okay, in functional group means in UNG and UNE is nothing but an GSGE in STS in ANSI X12. UNH and UNT is STSC in ANSI X12. Okay, so here we'll have a delimiter as plus, element delimiter as a plus. Okay, and also in ANSI X12s, we'll have a different beginning segments for all transactions. But in EDIFAC, we'll have only one beginning segment like BGM. After BGM, we'll have some orders, invoice, everything will be there. Okay, while in the ANSI X12, we'll have a unique segments for all transactions.
Okay.
And another difference is in ANSI X12, GS and GE functional group envelope is mandatory. But in the EDIFAC, whereas the functional group like UNG and UNE is optional. We can create or you may not create. That is optional. Here, UNA is service string advice. Okay. So we will not use much over that. So only UNB, UNZ, UNG, UNH, UNT, UNT only we will use. Okay. So this is all about EDIFAC. Now we are going to the individual elements of ISA standard.
So
in ISA standard, in ISA segment, as I said to you earlier, we'll have 16 elements. Okay. So what is the 16 elements? What is the, so here you can see the numeric one. The element ID here you see, right? All you can see in the map editor. Okay. So now these are all the element names. And M is mandatory, ID means integer, and AN means alphanumeric, means alphabets and integers also can be there. Here, if you can see here, the minimum length is 2, maximum length is 2, means it should be length of 2. So here 10 by 10, 2 by 2, 10 by 2. So complete length. So if you calculate all these lengths, you'll get number 106. That is called, that's why that ISA is a fixed length. Okay. So authorization is so still here, it's not a mandatory information like authorization information qualifier, authorization information, security information qualifier, security information. Always it will be 00 or else we'll use spaces. Okay. So from here it is mandatory interchange ID qualifier. Okay, for every senders or receivers, we'll have some qualifiers like ZZ or 0108. It's all trading partner wish. Okay, that is the qualifiers will be there. Sender ID. So who is sending, that their ID will be there. ID qualifier, receiver ID, date, time, replication separator. Sometimes it will be you, sometimes it will be another separator like. Okay, yes. Next, yeah, control version and control number. So for example, if you choose 850, so we'll have different versions. Okay, like 4010, 4030, 5010, 6010, 5030, 3010. Like this, some versions will be there for every transaction in ANSI Actual. That version is displayed in this 12th element. That's control number. The control number is, we'll call as an ICN, interchange control number. Whatever the control number you have seen in IA segment, the same control number should be seen under IA segment also. In IA segment also, we'll have a control number.
Yes.
ISA control number should match with IA control number. Then only we can say this document is a valid EDI document. Otherwise, it will be failed as an EDI compliance check. Okay. Next is acknowledgement requested. Means in ISA level. So we'll have number of acknowledgements. Okay. Yes. Now we are going with the ISA level acknowledgement. So in ISA level, acknowledgement means it will be 01. Okay. The value is 0 means they are not asking for acknowledgement. It is 1 means they are requesting for acknowledgement. Okay. That is acknowledge requested. And usage indicator. By the 415th element, by seeing this element, value can be T or P. If you see T, then you can say this document belongs to test. If you see as P, this document belongs to production.
Production.
Okay. Yeah. Next is component element separator. So always it is greater than, I too don't know how, why you will use everything, but always it will be greater than symbol. Okay. So these are all 16 elements of ANSI X12. Okay. So there are different elements. All are mandatory. For example, the interchange sender ID is the length is 15, but my trading partner's ID is only 10 spaces, means 10 only. Length is 10, but here we do have 15. That time we'll leave 5 spaces.
We can keep as a 5 spaces.
Yeah, just leave 10 after 10. So suppose Venkat is the sender ID. So V-E-N-K-A-T. So how many were 6 letters? So after that, the length should be 15 compulsory. So I will have 9 spaces.
Yes.
To have a complete 15 length. Okay. That is how we will do. So now coming to the IEA. Okay. So IEA is a closing tag of ISA segment. So first one is 01, means number of functional groups. Here, by seeing this segment, 01 element, okay, the value will be how many GSGE are there in one ISIA. That count will mention in the IEA first element. Understood, right? For example, in one ISA, one IEA, if you have one GSGE, means the number will be 1 here. If you find 2 GSGEs, means it will be 2 here. Second element is control number. Whatever the ISA 13th element, means control number is there, the same value should be in the second also. Okay. So this is how, what is IEA. Next is GS segment. We are going to GS segment. GS is a variable length. Okay. If you see, so the elements like 8 elements and element IDs and element names, mandatory, ID or alphanumeric. If you see here, the minimum length is 2, maximum length is 2. Sender code, 215 means 215. In between how many length also it can be there.
Okay.
So that's why it is variable length. Okay. First one is functional identifier code. For every transaction, we'll have just like an you can say alias name. Okay, how we are having pet name like that. So you can think in transactions also we'll have alias names. For example, for if you take a transaction purchase order, the purchase order functional identifier code is PO. If you take invoice, the functional identifier code is IN. So that value will present in the functional first one, GS first element. Okay, second, third element is sender code and receiver codes. Okay, means sender ID and receiver ID. Next, date and time. Next is control number. Here also we'll have a control number. That control number should match with the GE control number. Whatever the value present here, the same value should be present over there also. The next one is responsible agency code. Actually, frankly speaking, I too don't know what is use of it, but always we'll have a X here.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so the responsible agency code. And then the version, like how we are going with the versions like 4.0.1.0.3.0. The version name, it will be there in the 8th element. So these are the GS 8 elements.
One.
Okay.
I have a small question. In GS and ISA, we have a sender ID, receiver ID, right?
Yes, yes.
And difference between only the length, like 15 by 15 and 2 to 15. Only the difference will be the only length.
Sometimes it will be like, for example, in if you say Venkat, that again I should same answer for same question. So Venkat is only 6 letters. Okay. So in ISA, after Venkat, we leave 9 spaces. But in GS, no need to leave 9 spaces because it's a variable length. The minimum length is only 2. Now we are having 6 letters, so no need to leave the spaces. Just after that, it will be star only.
Okay. Right.
Okay. Now, yeah, GE first element is number of STSs in one GSGE. Okay, means how many STSs are there, that count will present in the GE. The second element is control number. Whatever control number you find in GS, the same control number should present in the GE also.
Okay,
now we are going to the ST segment, transaction segment. In ST segment, okay, we'll have two elements like transaction set identifier code means for purchase order in ANSI X12 we'll call as an 850. We'll call transactions, right? So transactions is 850. Okay, for that 855 we'll call, sorry, purchase order acknowledgement we'll call 855. For invoice we'll call 810. So that numbers will present in the ST first element. The second element is control number. So here also we'll have some unique number. That unique number which should match with the SC, the next element. Here 03 is very rare. You can see only for this version, 4.0.2.0, that version only we'll use 03. But 100%, 99% will have only two elements in ST segment. Okay.
Okay.
Now we are moving to the SC. SC means number of include segments. It means that how many in between ST SC, how many segments are there? So we'll have some segments, transaction segments like BEG, DTM, RA, some segments will be there. The count of segments, that value will present here, but here small change is you need to do always plus 2, number of between segments in STSC plus 2. So if you ask me why we need to plus 2 means, so just if only for STSC, apart from the between segments of STSC, you need to count ST plus SC.
Okay, including SC, ST.
Including ST and SC, you need to give the count here in 01 element. Okay, for SC element. Okay, how many elements are there between ST SC plus 2? Plus 2 means ST and SC also you need to count.
Okay,
next 02 is control number. Means whatever the control number in ST, the same control number should match with the 02 also. This is all about the ISA, GS, ST layer. Okay. Now, we are going to the retail industry flow. So, this is general flow, how we work usually. So you can say very simple. For example, if I'm going to a restaurant, okay, so first what they will give, first what you will ask, menu card, right? Okay, then you will come to know what items are available in the hotel, how much cost and everything. Okay, so that is called, after that he'll give a menu card, means you're getting response. Once you see the menu card, then you'll order something. Okay. And then if you order, that that bearer will say whether this item will be delivered shortly or it will take time, whether this item is available or not. Okay, everything you will be replied. This is nothing, acknowledgement for your order. And then after a couple of minutes, whatever you ordered, it will be delivered to on your bench, okay, table. So you will have it. You will have all those things. And then after a couple of after few minutes ago, you will receive a bill. Okay, nothing but invoice. And then by seeing this invoice, you will pay to him. Okay. So whatever you're doing, or the same thing you'll do in the retail industry also. There is no difference. Okay, retail industry also. If you see, we're having a buyer and seller. So yes. Buyer and seller. So if, for example, it a company called manufacturing company, Sensor and Paste, Horlicks, Closer Paste, all these are manufacturing. A company is GSK. Okay, that products are selling in many shops, like in Reliance Fresh or Walmart or Kmart. Okay, so in many retail shops are more Vijayta. So all retail, they are buying by from GSK, who is manufacturing. Yes. Or as wholesaler. So we'll have some wholesaler, something like, so buyer and seller. So first buyer will ask for quotation. Okay, nothing but 840. Okay, and then he'll give the response to buyer, will send quotation to the seller. So means this all we require and everything, any questions are there, they'll all, and the seller will send acknowledgement for the quotation what sent by the buyer. So 843, and then buyer will send an order. So what items he required from this seller, so he will send an order to the buyer, will send order to the seller using a transaction number called 850. Immediately after seeing the order, the seller will send an acknowledgement called 855. It's a purchase order acknowledgement. After that, seller will send the goods to the buyer. 856 is the advance shipment notification. The goods will be delivered using another transaction in the logistics department. Logistics though, but 856 is advance shipment notification. In that, we'll have when the goods are started delivered, okay, and then when it is shipped, and how your items are packed. Everything will mention in the 856. And after your goods are delivered, the seller will send an invoice to the buyer. Boss, this much has happened for you. They send an invoice. Once the buyer receives an invoice from seller, he will send an 820 as a payment. Okay, this is all about the retail industry flow. Any questions?
No.
Okay. So this is one of the sample file, how it look like. I'll show you later. So I say, if the star is element delimiter. So if you see, spaces are there. Because it's a fixed length, you need to leave the spaces. And security information qualifies security information. Authorization information qualifies authorization information. Interchange ID qualifies this sender ID. See, we are leaving some spaces to have 15 length. Next, interchange ID qualifies sender IDs. Date, time, usage indicator. Sorry, repetition separator. Interchange control version. So we'll have some versions like 00401. 501, 350, 30, like that. Yes. And then control number. Okay. So acknowledgement requested or not. Usage indicator. Component element separators. This is GS element. Okay. GS function. This one is incorrect. Function line because PO will be there. PO, IN or something will be there. IN, PR will be there like that. So senders, receivers, date and time, responsibility code and versions. ST. Transaction number like 850 and control number. So in between ST and SC, we'll have some transaction side segments. So that I'll show you tomorrow. So this is all about the layer of ancestral. Okay. Till now we discussed about the what is EDI and everything. So now I will show another one is supply chain management.
బిజ్టాక్ అనేది అక్కడ ఉంది కదా, ఏమన్నా చెప్తారా వాటి గురించి?
అది ఒక టూల్ అంతే, అది కూడా మన ఎస్ఐ లాగా, ఎస్ఐ ఎలా ఉందో సెల్లింగ్ ఇండికేటర్ కూడా వన్ ఆఫ్ ద టూల్ అన్నమాట. సో మన ఎస్ఐ చేసే ఫంక్షనాలిటీ సేమ్ బిజ్టాక్ చేస్తుంది, బట్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు ద మైక్రోసాఫ్ట్. సెల్లింగ్ ఇండికేటర్ అంటే బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఐబిఎం కదా, అలాగే బిజ్టాక్ ఐ మైక్రోసాఫ్ట్ వాట్ టూల్ అన్నమాట. ఓకే
ఓకే.
సో అక్కడ కూడా మనకి 850 అక్కడ కూడా ఈడీఐ ఉంటుంది, బట్ ఏంటంటే ఫంక్షనాలిటీ సేమే కానీ ప్రాసెస్ వేరే ఉంటుంది. ఇక్కడ మీరు చేయాలంటే ఒకలా ఫాలో అవుతుంది, అక్కడ ఒకలా ఫాలో అవుతుంది, బట్ అవుట్పుట్ ఏమీ సేమే.
ఓకే.
హలో అక్కడ అవన్నీ ఏంటంటే మన టూ మెథడ్స్ ఉంటాయి, ఒక సింటాక్స్ రికార్డ్ అని డెలిమీటర్స్ అని. ఓకే, సో డెలిమీటర్స్ అంటే మనం మెన్షన్ చేయాలి అక్కడ మ్యాపింగ్ లో, మెన్షన్ చేయాలి. అలా కాదు, సపోజ్ ఇప్పుడు ఇది ఇంటర్వ్యూ క్వశ్చన్, భయ్యా మీరు అడిగిన క్వశ్చన్ ఇప్పుడు ఇంటర్వ్యూ క్వశ్చన్ అది. ఓకే, సో జనరల్ గా ఏంటంటే టూ టైప్స్ ఉంటాయి. ట్రేడింగ్ ప్యాన్ అనేవాడు ఎప్పుడు అదే పంపిస్తాను అనుకోండి, మనకి ఇప్పుడు ఒకటే స్పెషల్ క్యాటగరీ, ఎప్పుడు డెలిమీటర్ అదే పంపిస్తారా అంటే హార్డ్ కోడ్ చేస్తాం మనం. అలా కాదు, వాడు ఒకసారి ఒకటి పంపిస్తాడు, ఒకసారి ఇంకోటి పంపిస్తాడు అంటే సింటాక్స్ రికార్డ్ అని ఒక ఆప్షన్ ఉంటుంది భయ్య. సింటాక్స్ రికార్డ్ ఏంటంటే లెంగ్త్ బట్టి చేస్తాం అనమాట మనం, ఎందుకంటే అందుకే ఐఎస్ అనేది ఫిక్స్డ్ లెంగ్త్. ఈ ప్రాబ్లమ్ అకంప్లిష్ అవడానికి దాన్ని ఫిక్స్డ్ లెంగ్త్ పెట్టారు. సో ఫిక్స్డ్ లెంగ్త్ టోటల్ లెంగ్త్ 106 కదా.
అప్పుడు థర్డ్ లెంగ్త్ ఐఎస్
ఐఎస్ తర్వాత ఉన్నది ఎలిమెంట్ డెలిమిటర్ తీసుకోమని చెప్తాం మనం.
అప్పుడు ఆ సింటాక్స్ రికార్డ్
ఆటోమేటిక్ గా తీసుకుంటుంది అన్నమాట. దానికి డెలిమిటర్ సంబంధం లేదు అప్పుడు, ఇంకా స్పేసిల్ తోటి సంబంధం. ఆ స్పేసిల్ కూడా కరెక్ట్ గా ఉంటాయి, ఇది ఐఎస్ లెంగ్త్ కాబట్టి.
ఇప్పుడు థర్డ్ సెగ్మెంట్ ఇందాక అక్కడ మొత్తం స్పేస్ ఉంది అంటే మ్యాపింగ్ లో వాళ్ళు అక్కడ ఏమి మనకి ఏం ఆప్షన్ ఇవ్వలేదు అనుకోండి, ఈ థర్డ్ సెగ్మెంట్ ఇది మ్యాప్ చేయండి అని. సో అది ఆటోమేటిక్ గా వర్షన్ ప్రకారం మనం ఏం మ్యాప్ చేయలేదు కాబట్టి
ఏం చేయము ఇంకా. అది ఫస్ట్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్
మనం రికార్డ్ చేయాలా, ఏమి ఇవ్వకపోతే ఇలా
ఇది ఉంటుంది. ఇక్కడ క్లిక్ చేశారనుకోండి, ట్యాగ్ నేమ్ ఐఎస్ఏ, దాని పొజిషన్ అంటది లెంగ్త్ 106. ఓకే, ఇవన్నీ వాల్యూస్ ఉంటాయి అన్నమాట, ఒక దానికి వాల్యూస్ ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, ఇవన్నీ మనకి ఎట్లా దొరికేస్తాయి, ట్యాగ్ నేమ్ ఇక్కడ ఐఎస్ఏ ఇవ్వాలి. సో వాట్ ఆర్ ద వాల్యూస్ ఉన్నాయి అవన్నీ ఈజీ కాపీ చేసాను అన్నమాట. ఇక్కడ కంటెంట్ చెక్ చేయాలి, పొజిషన్ 1 లో. ఓకే, రేంజ్ కంటే బ్లాంక్ లెంగ్త్ 106, ట్యాగ్ డిలీట్ పొజిషన్, డెలిమీటర్ పొజిషన్ 4, మొత్తం 106. మళ్ళీ డెలిమీటర్ పొజిషన్ ఎలిమెంట్ మళ్ళీ 4. సో ఈ యాస్టర్ ఇచ్చేస్తాం అనమాట మనం. సో ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ఏంటంటే ఓన్లీ పొజిషన్ మ్యాపింగ్ లో ఇక్కడ. ఓకే, డెలిమీటర్ పొజిషన్స్ ఇవన్నీ డిఎల్ సార్, డెలిమీటర్ పొజిషన్స్ అనమాట. డెలిమీటర్ పొజిషన్, ట్యాగ్, సెగ్మెంట్, ఎలిమెంట్, రిపీటింగ్ ఎలిమెంట్, సబ్ ఎలిమెంట్, ఇవన్నీ ఇచ్చేస్తాం అలాగా. ఓకే, ట్యాగ్ లెంగ్త్ వచ్చేటప్పుడు ఏంటంటే ఇర్రెస్పెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ డెలిమీటర్స్ సంబంధం లేదు, మిస్ ఏ డెలిమీటర్ పంపించినా యాక్సెప్ట్ చేస్తుంది. ఎందుకంటే వీఆర్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ వయా డెలిమీటర్స్, జస్ట్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ వయా లెంగ్త్. ఐఎస్ఐ ఫిక్స్డ్ లెంగ్త్ అండ్ స్టాండర్డ్ కాబట్టి అవే ఫాలో అవుతాం. ఇక్కడ సింపుల్ సింపుల్ డెలిమీటర్స్ ఉన్నాయి అనుకోండి, స్పెసిఫిక్ కామన్ డెలిమీటర్స్ అనుకోండి, ఇక్కడ ఆ డెలిమీటర్స్ ఇస్తాం అనమాట మనం. ఓకే.